God knows I'm not. I'm kind of a professional skeptic. But Scientology has been one of these. And talk about love bombing. You know, I have gotten 15, 20 calls a week by some of these local members of the Buffalo org of Scientology. Right. And man, I like them. They're sweet and kind, and they seem sincere and caring people. So, and maybe that's beside the point. We're talking right now really about...
No, it isn't beside the point. It's a very key point that you walked in, you liked them. That's the point.
But I haven't even stepped foot in the door yet. I just bought a book, a Dianetics book, over a year ago, and that's all that's happened so far. So I'm amazed at the eagerness, the self-discipline this organization shows at reaching out. Isn't that, though, what all religions do? They all kind of, you know, spread the gospel, go door to door, try to drum up support.
Sure, but they don't do these abusive things like stopping free speech, fair game, breaking up families, medical abuse that I know of.
So your big issue with Scientology is less the implausible beliefs and more their practices. Will Smith had this quote recently where he says, there's nothing in Scientology more outlandish than in other religions, like that a woman can have a baby without ever getting pregnant. So you're not railing against the doctrines that are implausible.
No, because I was raised a Catholic where they go on Sunday and eat the body and blood of Jesus Christ, right? So to me, it's like every religion has their own little things that and other people might go, that's kind of kooky. So to me, Zeno's kooky, and some people can argue it forever, but why you can always pull in the religious thing and there it goes. But these abuses, every church is going to say, well, we don't do that. And so anybody can stand up and say, well, I am for free speech. And if they're cutting that off, that's not right.
Let's talk about some of the other abuses. You mentioned they were against your taking medication for epilepsy, but Christian Science is also against people taking medication.
I understand, but I'm not for Christian Science either. I believe in medicine. Let's stick with Scientology, because most religions are not against medicine.
Hmm.
I mean, you can look up Lisa McPherson. She was locked in a room for 17 days. Forget about medicine. She was locked in a room for 17 days, died with bug bites and bruises all over her. And you can look it up, lisamcpherson.org, and read all about it. That was in the Church of Scientology. There's no Christian Science that's done something like that.
Tell me about Lisa McPherson. Tell me about the trust, Lisa McPherson Trust.
Lisa McPherson was a person who wanted to leave Scientology, basically, and just went out. You know, took off her clothes. She went a little bit nuts, took off her clothes, wanted to get attention, wanted to go to a mental institute, you know, kind of the mental side of things and get away from Scientology. They came and snagged her and said, we'll take care of her, locked her in a room for 17 days, and she's dead.
So she was having emotional problems. She wanted to seek medical attention. She wasn't allowed.
Because they locked her in a room for 17 days, wouldn't talk to her, and some other torturous things that you can read about on the net.
Mm.
It wasn't just she died because she didn't get medical treatment. She died because they locked her in a room and wouldn't talk to her.
So as we're recounting these stories of abuses reportedly enacted by the Church of Scientology, that really drives home the point that you left not because of the doctrines, but because of these practices.
Oh, definitely, because of the abuses. I was in their top secret gang, where I was opening up these phony accounts. So this is my thing. They're like complaining about Anonymous. It's like, hang on. These guys are way more covert, doing way nastier things.
Tell me about the Office of Special Affairs in this regard.
Okay, the Office of Special Affairs is Scientology's PR/legal/dirty tricks department. They'll say PR legal, but underneath that are their dirty tricks, are all under the Office of Special Affairs.
And what kind of things do they do?
Well, they've done all kinds of things. You can go on the net. They've written thousands of lies about me, as an example, right?
Yeah, they say that you're doing what you're doing against the church because you're being paid by other organizations or detractors.
And they give me $1 paid by anybody, number one. I've never been paid by anybody to speak out. I left on the internet. So that's a flat-out lie. If I can say you're a pedophile, does that mean it's true? Hell no.
Right. And in fact, I heard that maybe it is just hearsay, but when they discover that you're a suppressive person, that they do things like spread rumors about you being a pedophile or a a thief or a criminal.
Now, first of all, they don't discover you're a suppressive person. They declare you a suppressive person. There's a big difference there. Finding out assumes you are. The truth is, they, as soon as you expose any of the things they don't want known, that's their solution. Declare them a suppressive, cut them off. That's why people can't, you go, how could this happen? But that's a huge part of it. You're not allowed to read those books. Now, remember, I was a free speech advocate when I got in. By the time I got up to the top, it's kind of like a pyramid, right?
Mm-hmm.
I'd been cut off from books, cut off. They don't watch a lot of news. They, you know, a lot of things can come out that they won't hear or see.
Help me step back a little and answer the kind of the broader question. How do people who advocate for critical thinking and the scientific worldview, how do we keep people from being sucked in to organizations that suppress critical thinking and free thought, like you're describing Scientology as?
A huge part of it is education. Just like this picket, that's an international picket this Sunday, right, around the world.
That Anonymous is organizing.
That Anonymous is organizing, and that's going to be fantastic because it's going to bring up the awareness for many, many people via signs, via, you know, communication, that's something they should look into. The Internet is a terrific source. There's a lot of information on the Internet people can go and read. You know, I always say, don't believe me. Go look on the net. You know, do your own research. But find out. You know, my thing is this. I keep it very simple because people don't have a long attention span to listen. So I just say, I was in Scientology. I escaped out. Now, you guys weren't, so you wouldn't say that. But you could say there's an other side to Scientology. They're sort of like the Truman Show. And most people have seen that movie. If they haven't, tell them to rent it and watch it. That's how it is. And the actual facts of it are on the Internet. People can type in Scientology, and there's their side, which is all how great it is, and then there's the other side, which is all the other stuff.
Why would someone who's interested in science and reason be zeroing in on Scientology and not, say, Mormonism or another religion in general? In other words, why does Scientology get the biggest bullseye for my rationalist friends when they're up in arms, when they're decrying how dangerous, you know, a so-and-so cult is?
Well, I think it started with Tom Cruise's video and Scientology insisting that they take it down. I don't know that Mormonism, I don't know that much about it, but I don't think they actively stop free speech on the net. Scientology does. And that got the interest of a lot of people going, hang on, you know, which is the same thing that happened in the 90s. So I said to them when I was in, you, Scientology, are creating your own enemies. And I've said it since I left on tape, on film, to David Miscavige. Here I am, David.
David Miscavige is the current head of the Church of Scientology.
He's the head of Scientology. Get a grip. People aren't going away. The Internet's here to stay. So get honest. Get straight. Tell the truth. If you're not scientific, you know, fine. Admit it. Say, this is what we think. Do you see what I mean? This is what we believe. But they don't want to say that. You're either a religion or a science. You're not both.
What amazes me, kind of from the armchair historian of religion's point of view, that the Church of Scientology doesn't want just to be a religion, but they're really hanging on the prestige that science has. I mean, they call themselves Scientology. They're appealing to the authority that science has in our culture.
Right, and I say to everyone that's in the point of inquiry, you know, start looking into it. Start passing on the websites, because one of the biggest things they do that's very bad is they rope in young kids, sign them into a billion-year contract, cut off their critical thinking skills. And you all, that's one of the best things you could do, is teach people about critical thinking and how does someone get cut off from that. There's some very specific information on how, on mind control, how it works.
You just mentioned, in quotes, roping in youngsters. Here in upstate New York, there was a lot of hullabaloo over the last year or so as the Church of Scientology started reaching out to the University of Buffalo, which is the largest campus of the largest state school system in the United States. Is that something you know about? Are they focusing on the campuses more now than they used to? They're also experiencing growth in the third world, right?
That's what they promote. they always promote their featuring growth. Whether they really are or not, I say drive by their organization, most of them are empty. So whether they are or not, they're always promoting to the college students because college students are often looking for something else. And so, they say, you can get this, we can do that, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, they make promises about really solving all your life's problems with this new secret technology. Scientologists call it tech, lost tech that L. Ron Hubbard has revealed to humanity, not just humanity, but all life in the universe, right?
Of which I will state, I spent 30 years following that carrot. Remember the little donkey that's plodding along with the carrot in front of him? I, believe it or not, I believed all of that, and I fought it, got to the top, and found out it's a completely dead-end street. And I tell everyone, don't believe me, go look on the internet, study other stories, find out from other people, make up your own mind.
Thank you very much for joining me on Point of Inquiry, Tori Christman.
You're so welcome. I think it was a really good interview.